Hey guys, it's Queendija, and in today's video, I will be reacting to episodes 5 and 6 of Working Season 4. So, other than that, let's go ahead and get started with episode 5 in 3, 2, 1, go. Ain't that funny? Winter, December. Except it ain't snowing here in Florida. Except that one time before I moved here. Can I still say that Higa and Mia's relationship is going hella fast than our previous lovers? Because, I mean, it took 3 seasons. And you telling me one season. Well, I mean, you know what? No. You know why? Because of Higa's VA. His VA is just, that voice. I mean, he's not playing a really good-looking character in this show. Higa's okay. Like, honestly. His voice is like 20,000. You like the voice, yes. The character, he cute, but he ain't that cute. He adorable, but he cute little baby. If I had the chance, I'd take him out on a cute little date. Just a coffee date. But if you wish, you know. Gojo Sensei Hawks. Girl. Tatsuya. So 10,000 yen, basically. He's just asking. Excuse me? Yes, she is. She's right. Look at the baby. I love kids so much. Do you do, like, some other job? Like, what's his face? Oh. That makes sense. I mean, yeah, because he looks like such a teddy bear. He doesn't seem like the type of person who would kick ass. I mean, he's very similar to, what's his face from School Rumble?
Oh, Mingo!
Uh-oh. Okay, hold on. Isn't it funny that the guy with the bandage on his head looks very similar to the dude from Daily Lives of High School Boys, aka one of my favorite shows that I reacted to? Oh, I miss my old channel. Makes me still hate YouTube, because YouTube hates me, you know? I mean, he is kind of great. He's, oh my god, stop. Her daughter just looking at her like, what the fuck, mom? Yeah, were you just walking home one day and you were like, hey, let me just try? Sure. No, we got time. Oh, that looks good. I'm hungry. Where? Okay, I mean, that's not bad. It's technically not a date, but it's kind of hurt. What? How stupid! You tried. But you're good at it, though. Yeah, you want to make some remember somebody's name. Sayuri, or just Yuri for short. Okay. Okay, Siho. Well, okay, yes, and I think if she fixes it, you might be able to smile. I mean, come on, when a customer comes in, you're supposed to smile. Excuse me? She won a hot... Whoa! Okay! You know, honestly, I have too, except I don't work there. I'm sitting here watching y'all. I mean, the shenanigans that these characters get into, it, like, the bar between the original to this new cast, you're like, the fuck? They messy, but they messy funny in a good way. And that's what I like about them. Oh, shit. He tripped. He about to die. Who? Hey, She-Ho. Are you serious? But I don't wait. She you're supposed to sing it out of Zaki and I hear that. And Zaki just fall. What the hell? Oh, I feel so bad for him and not understanding, like, oh, if only everybody had the chance to learn the language so that everyone could understand. Oh, God. No. It's just a complicated love triangle. Hi, baby! Yeah, I mean, Yana, when you just have that scarf, you're instantly gonna get cold. You need, like, a coat. Because, you know, the idiot people in Florida here, they don't like to wear coats. They like to wear shorts because everybody thinks it's just summer here all day, every day. It's not. Unless you're coming somewhere when it's really, really cold and then coming here, yeah, you're gonna get hot. But don't be like some of these people here. Don't come here. If you do, you come for certain places. That's it. Yeah. Her mom's cute. So then it makes me wonder, like, will Yuri have to take over the family business after? Well, yeah, because I bet you she talks about you to her. Oh, okay, never mind. He doesn't have one! Oh my god, what? And then what happened? Oh shit. Did he die? Okay, good, 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 good. Thank God. Oh. Yeah. So maybe Adachi, you shouldn't hang out with Yuri anymore. So, you want to hang out with Yana, best girl? Chino? Chino. Hold up, wait. Time out. Does he need that much? Well, at least she's not like Oto-san's wife. I mean, like, she got lost too damn much. Can we have an episode about Yana, Yana only? I mean, she is literally best girl. Of course you are, Yanagiba. Are you serious? So she could be like what? 30? Okay. Are you gonna blackmail them? Like Yeah, and plus there's too much tension between the two of you, so, I mean, Well, I mean, okay, Higa is plain looking, but he still is attractive, so, I mean, come on now, I'm just, I date him. I mean, but okay, you never know. Like, Higa might actually, like, blossom into, you know, a man. He a boy. Like, he, like, what, 16, 17? Ooh, never mind. No. He can still change. Get a haircut, maybe work out. And the next, you know, he'd be looking like an idiot, like, ho. Oh, let me stop. Really? Really? Aww. Are you sure? I mean, okay, hold on. Can we start with something else besides chocolate? Like, chocolate is like a level 10 chef. Mia, you like level 0.5, negative 0.5. There ain't even no negative than a zero. You like negative 200. Nah, somebody's just talking about you. Yeah. I'm just looking right at you. Yeah, Mia! Are you serious? But okay. So, look, as much as I want Mia to make him chocolate, like, we can't start with, like, spaghetti or curry, like, really level one type dishes. Like, yes, I mean, a dish like chocolate or something sweet like chocolate seems like something that's level one, but nah, because I don't know what in the world she put in that chocolate. That's like freaking Umi from Irregular Magic High School, with the fact is this girl put espresso in her chocolate. Ain't add no sugar. Did she add sugar? No, she ain't even add sugar. That's not chocolate. Chocolate is chocolate, and it's good. I mean, as someone who's about to go on a diet and not have anything sweet for, like, the whole month, I might die. But, no, I might not, because, honestly, I've gone months sometimes without eating chocolate. But, yeah, I don't know. I want Mia try something else before chocolate again. We don't want Higa to die. Oh, hi, honey. Hmm? Oh my god, her voice is so cute. Hi. No. She weird, but that's okay. She cute and adorable, and I love her, and I would literally, like, kill for that child. You know, honestly, really, every character for this series and the previous series, I would kill for, because, you know, these characters for both of these shows are just so good and just so relatable. I don't know how, this cast will be relatable to me, but, like, with the previous cast, yeah, I see that, but, like, this cast, I mean, I still love this cast. At the end of the day, Sometimes I'll be like, what the fuck? But like, it's like, oh my god, what is that stupid freaking gif that I see every single time I go on Twitter? Like, you know, when you come back, it's the gif where it's the guy coming back with pizza, and like, the whole house has gone to chaos and shit, and there's like a fire, and people are like, hey! That is this show every episode that I watch. I'm like, what the fuck am I watching? Is this the same series? Even though this isn't the same characters, but I love them for that. It's just, it's so freaking good, even though it can be very random at times, and I'm like, what the fuck is this? But it's so cute. I mean, I can't. But I hope that, you know, Mia takes her time on cooking, read the instructions, and then when you think, like, okay, this is what I do when I cook, especially when I'm cooking something that I've never cooked before for the first time. I remember making, like, these cheddar bacon ranch burgers and stuff. The first couple of times, I will follow the ingredients, like, as it tells me. So, if it tells me I need, like, 1/3 tablespoon or teaspoon of a packet of ranch mix, or I need this, or I need that, your girl is gonna follow that bit by bit by bit. But once I get to maybe, like, my 10th, or my 12th time making it, and I know it pretty by far, that's when I'm like, fuck the manual, like, nobody reads the manual, I know how to do this-ish, and I've still gotten it down. I haven't made them in, like, five years? Like, yeah. Yeah, 5 years, about 5 years. But I remember, I think, no, I made, like, just regular old ranch burgers with a little bit of cheddar in it and, no bacon. But I was still good. I'm still good at cooking. Like, I can make a mean spaghetti, chicken Alfredo, some nachos, some really good chicken. I make some really bomb-ass chicken. What else can I make? Meatloaf, almost like anything that you really personally want. American dishes. I've never really tried, like, any other dish from, like, a different country. So, my biggest goal is to make curry. Like, authentic Japanese curry. And I have an Asian store, like, right over, not even across the street, right down the road from me. And I can go up there anytime. But, you know, your girl don't feel like walking. Especially now that it's getting colder outside, and it's like, nope, get in that car, get all nice and toasty warm, and drive down there, which is only gonna take me 3 minutes, but, yeah, I mean, I just, let's kind of just, you know, inch Mia up to making chocolate again, you know, hype her up, and like, yeah, you can do this, you got this, and just don't fuck up again, but go ahead and pause the video, and I'll see you guys in 1 second for episode 6. Okay, episode 6 in 3, 2, 1, go. About what? I'm scared for him. I feel like the next time he is going to eat a next one of Mia's chocolate, it's gonna kill him. Or worse. Ugh. You know, one day I will make chocolate for, like, my future okay. Honestly, you know what? Would you rather have, like, homemade chocolate, or would you rather want store-bought chocolate? My thing is this, like, do a year where you and your significant other both make homemade chocolate. You either follow that directions or you wing it, but you still need to use sugar, especially if you are using, not only bittersweet, but if you're using, like, those, like, other melting chocolates, because, yes, they melt good, but sometimes they don't put enough sugar in there, and you just need to be, like, put it in there. Not too much, though, but you need to put sugar in chocolate, because, ish. You don't want that. You don't want somebody to die. I can't imagine putting, like, hot sauce. Okay, I can't imagine having chocolate and having hot sauce and chocolate together. No. Like, hot chocolate? No. Hot, spicy chocolate? What is wrong with you? No. Oh, God, I'm scared. Is it good? Damn. No, I don't. Those look like coupons. She really scares me. Like, oh my God, I love her though. You're really gonna check. Oh, Gary, you didn't have to. Oh. Oh my God! Just gave him chocolate. Oh, damn. No, just give him damn. Oh, shit. Okay, but hold on. Did y'all taste test the chocolate, though? Yes. For his life, though. Yeah, because you know, if she fucks up, you have a chance to give him some bomb ass chocolate and be like, oh my God, Higa, I like you. So, yeah, he's okay. No, I think you succeeded. Like this, what the fuck? Oh, Jesus. I know, like, Mia, what the hell did you put in your chocolate this time? But you know, hey, Higa, at least you aren't getting punched because, bruh. Please, no. Okay. See, yeah, that's not Yana, that is Chino. Oh my god! Oh my god, he's so adorable! You know, Shiho, I'm gonna say it. You know, your best girlfriend, a girlfriend, is showing a lot. Kind of a little bit of, you know, your persona showing too, but that's okay. Yeah, her Kasumi definitely came out. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh. Yuri, at least you're, you know, understanding and compassionate. Or you're afraid of her. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because that used to be me, and now I just love horror movies. Yuri wasn't supposed to hear that, I'm sorry. Excuse me. Kind of. I mean, it depends on the girl, you know. She's so cute. Okay, I thought you were gonna say you knew that he liked you. Hurry, Yamada! Let's just break shit! What the fuck?! It would just make your day, right? Well, really? Okay, so then what are you gonna make instead of chocolate? Then you just go forward with it. Oh my god, that was so fucking cute. I'm dead. I am dead. Kids. Oh my god. Yeah. Oh, Jesus. You know, Shiho. What? No! 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 I'm like freaking Yashiro! Oh, Jesus. Oh, he's so cute. Yeah. What's up? She probably has. You can see she's thinking about it. Daichi? Yeah, she still don't remember you. Oh, she's even cuter as a kid. That's okay. Not everyone usually does, and that's fine. Oh, damn. See, you know, the way her VA goes, she would be really perfect into doing, if they ever wanted to do an anime on BDSM, I mean, damn. Right there. We've seen little bits and pieces in other animes, but, you know, one day, it's going to be a TV MA rated show, and I'm just going to be like, there you go! It finally happened! I mean, but yeah, she always definitely a Satanist. But, whoo, shit. Oh, I thought you were wearing a wig. That's fine. Yeah. Probably not. Poor baby. That is his hell. Poor Daichi. Aww. Oh, of course, but at the same time, you're spending time with her, so. Yeah, if she wanna be lazy and stay here, it's fine. She's okay. Mia, this ain't no braid up gotcha ish. I feel like you're never gonna get it right. You might kill him soon. Oh, this just got complicated. Damn. He really means that, though. Oh, God. I wonder how the second half of the show is going to go now. I mean, but okay, let's say Mia makes like a really good chocolate. Who knows, really? Because, I mean, we're going to say it once again, right up is a lie. This child, I mean, she's like, yeah, I can make you some good chocolate. This is that and the third. Instead of just, you know, regular old chocolate. Because, I mean, he wants something else. But I feel like if she is not good at making chocolate, she is not good at making anything else. Right up is a mother effing lie. Don't. No. She even got help, and she still sucked at it. How is it that you still got help from somebody and you still sucked? I mean, I don't understand. I'm confused. Like, how do you fuck up a chocolate? Not even chocolate, let alone any food. But still, especially when you have help. Help! Okay, but then what about Daichi? Okay, Yuri. Right? I mean, damn, Kiza.
Oh my god, look at her.
But it's complicated. The love triangles, it ain't no love wars, thank god. I mean, it ain't like, yeah, pick a side, and then, you know, three or four seasons later, we find out whoever this girl or guy is gonna get with. Oh, guys, yeah, that's why sometimes, you know, I hate some, not hate, I dislike some romance animes where it is a whole bunch of guys and one girl, or a whole bunch of girls and one guy, and then you're like, I shift this character with this character, and then in the end, you get pissed because the character you wanted to get with that character doesn't get with that character in the end, and you're just like, I wasted so much time watching this show, unless the show is really good. But, especially, I mean, Yuri, there's two good-looking guys, Daichi and both, Adachi, they're both interesting. I don't know, I think if it was me, would I take Daichi? I mean, I don't know, I can't even answer that right now. Ask me in, like, two episodes, maybe even four, but, like, I don't know. That's a really hard question, because all the guys in here are, all the guys in this series are very good looking. They have, like, qualities that, you know, any girl or guy, whatever, float your boat for, you know, whatever team you're on. something that, you know, possibly is attracted to them. I mean, but, you know, it ain't no Sato. Sato was the best damn boy of season 1 and 3. I mean, come on. He was the hottest freaking guy. He was that one bad boy that, you know, well, semi-bad boy that, you know, the mothers and the fathers and everyone else says, no, don't date him. Like, he's bad. And then you're like, no. I'm gonna date him because he's bad. But then at the same time, I can change him. But it was more of his feelings. Like, the one thing that I loved about Sato is that slowly but surely, he got his feelings out to Yajiro, and the fact that they're still together, like, ah! Still one of the best moments in that damn show, like, oh, I can't. That and Popular and her short ass, like, oh my god. I miss that show so much. I kind of just want to, like, you know, I wish I could have, like, a memory, like, my memory, like, taken away from me so that I could just watch the show all over again. Because it was so good, and I miss it. But yeah, I just very complicated for the next few episodes. Who knows what the hell is gonna happen next? But other than that, guys, that's my reaction view towards episodes 5 and 6 of season 4 of Working. If you guys enjoyed it, please give me a like. Really helps me out. Also, subscribe to my channel. I make videos every single day. Join the Matchless Squad, and of course, I will see you guys officially on next Friday for Patreons and next Thursday for everybody else for episodes 7 and 8. Bye, guys.